It's live. Have you shared PPT, ma'am?
No, I'll try.
Just.
Yes, I have shared. Can you see, sir, now?
Yeah, it's preparing.
Okay. Yeah.
First of all, I will introduce my faculty, our faculty in charge, Dr. Sachin Tavade, sir. He is also head department of botany and in charge for our faculty of science. Dr. Tavade, sir, are you there?
Yes, sir. Good afternoon.
Yeah.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, sir.
Arvind, sir.
Yes, sir.
We have to start the program or I have to do some activity here?
No. Just we are going. Just let me live the session properly on YouTube and then we will start the session.
Okay.
Yes. Sir, just admit the person those are in waiting room.
Yes. Yes, I'm doing that one.
Yes, sir. Dear participant, faculty members, resource person, first of all, at the outset of this new session of 17 days of Countrywide Classroom Teaching Program, I welcome you all. Actually, this is a post-lunch session and ma'am, today we have a three session.
So
your session is the third session, which is a post-lunch session. But we are hoping that everyone will like a lunch, will have a knowledgeful and fruitful session today. As ma'am has a huge biodata, ma'am currently working as a principal at Annasaheb GD Bendale Mahavidyalaya Jalgaon. First of all, I take this opportunity to introduce Principal Professor Gauri Milind Rane Madam. With a short CV, even though ma'am has a huge biodata, but due to the constraint of time, we are not taking all this activity of all the position that ma'am hold. But short and few of the important the position that I will describe here. Ma'am is a professor in botany since 2014. Ma'am teaching experience is around 38 years. And ma'am hold some position in the Northern Maharashtra University of Jalgaon. Ma'am has a member of management council of Kavitri Bainabai Chaudhary Northern Maharashtra University Jalgaon. Then ma'am also act as a senate member. Ma'am also has a board of studies and botany, member of ad hoc board of studies in diploma in agriculture as well as natural resources. Ma'am also a member for the ad hoc board of the studies of BO courses. Madam also hold a position in the HGBU Santa Gadge Baba Amravati University Amravati as the board of studies members in the botany. Madam has a huge academic experience of 34 years in teaching as well as in research. I will not take all the position that ma'am holds.
Make it very short, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm 34 years experienced teacher in botany. That is sufficient, I think.
Yes, exactly. And ma'am has a 28 year of research experience in post. Madam also has a postgraduate teacher. Ma'am has presented more than 100 plus papers in conferences, symposia and workshops. And madam has a major research project completed. Nine major research projects. One of the recognized major project was a model waste watershed development project. Ma'am work as a principal investigator and team leader for that, with the sponsored by the Minister of Agriculture, Government of India, and in collaboration with ICRSTA Hyderabad for the collected district Jalgaon. And The amount is around 42 lakh rupees. And many other project madam has already pulled. Another is biodiversity protection, agriculture development in the Jalgaon. That project was from the Milan city of Council, Italy and Sinai. Then Purma University, Italy and district collector of the Jalgaon. So such a huge project madam has already completed. And madam has a total of 12 publication UGC listed journal, peer review journal and referee journal publication 35. And madam has till date published 47 book in botany. Okay, so this is a huge biodata of ma'am. So I request Gauri Rana madam to proceed for his lecture on a topic systematic botany in this countrywide classroom teaching program 17 days noon second session. Ma'am, the session with this precise biodata, I request you to take a charge of this session. Gauri Rana madam, please,
thank
session
you,
is over to you.
Thank you, sir, for the nice introduction. First of all, I would like to thank the authorities, the honorable management members of this Parent Education Trust of your college, the principal and other team of your college for organizing such a unique countrywide classroom teaching program 2021. So that we can meet the students across the Maharashtra and students of Maharashtra get benefited to listen to the teachers from different regions of Maharashtra. So thank you, sir, one and all. Now I would like to start my presentation. Today I'm planning to talk about two plant families, which are very significant plant families. Of course, I have chosen these families as per the syllabus of SRTM University, Nanded. So the very first family I'm going to talk about is family Mimosaceae. This Mimosaceae, you can call it as commonly as bubble family. Now, whenever we study any plant family, first we have to see the systematic position or what is the classification of this particular family. We all know that angiosperms, these flowering plants, yes, sir.
Excuse me, I'm sorry to interrupt you. Yes, your PPT is not visible. Only black screen is there. Have you shared anything?
Yes, sir. It's there on the screen. You can't see?
No, it is a blank screen. Ma'am, firstly, do one thing. Okay. You open your PPT on the screen, then share the PPT.
Okay.
You have the PDF. So, firstly, open the PPT on desktop and then go to Zoom meeting and
So I have to again join the meeting, right? Sir, I can't hear you now.
Ma'am.
Yes, sir.
You do not need to leave Zoom meeting.
Mm-hmm.
Stay in the meeting.
Okay.
Just go to your folder, then open PDF. Yeah. Firstly, open your PDF.
Okay.
Okay. Now go to Zoom meeting and share screen. Are you able to do, ma'am?
Yes, I'm doing, sir. But I don't know why it is.
Yeah, okay. ma'am. Okay.
So let me share one second.
Yes.
Yes. Is it visible, sir, now?
Yes, ma'am, it is visible. Okay. Just go ahead.
Okay. So to begin with, I have chosen these two families as per the syllabus of SRT Minister Nande. The first family is Mimosaceae, which is commonly called as bubble family. Now, for studying any plant family, before that we see the systematic position or classification of that particular family. First of all, it is belonging to division Phanerogams, where all flowering vascular plants has come. It is further divided into subdivision angiosperms, and obviously the character is seeds are enclosed in the fruit. Angios means closed, seeds are enclosed within the fruit. Now this subdivision is further divided into three classes, dicotyledons, monocotyledons. Now these dicotyledons, they are characterized by five distinct characters which you can find in each and every dicotyledonous plant. That is taproot system. There is a single strong taproot which penetrates into the soil. It multiplies later, but the main root is taproot. The stem is branched. You will never find unbranched stem. Stem is branched. The seed, the leaves are with reticulate venation. The veins, they are multiplied into veinlets and they form a mesh or a network in the lamina. So it is reticulate venation. The flowers are pentamerous. Penta is five. So all the floral parts are either five in number or in multiple of five. So this flower is described as pentamerous flower. And the important character where the name lies, dicotyledons, is the seeds are with two cotyledons. So whenever seed germinates, the first pair of seedling has two leaves. So we can see those are the two cotyledons. It is further divided into three subclasses, polypetaly, gamopetaly, and opetaly. This family belonging to subclass polypetaly. Poly is free, so obviously the character is petals are free. The series is calyciflora. Now there are three series, thalamiflora, pisciflora, and calyciflora. The thalamiflora is characterized by presence of conical conspicuous thalamus. The pisciflora has disc-shaped thalamus and calyciflora has cup-shaped thalamus. And the important character is perigynous flower. Perigynous flower is a very unique flower. So before going for perigynous flower, let us see what is hypogynous and what is epigynous. Now this is a flower. All of you can see this image, I hope. This is the thalamus, which is the green part. And on this thalamus, you can see this ovary, style, and stigma. Now here, you can see the ovary occupies the topmost position. The calyx, the corolla, and the androecium, it arises from the base of the ovary. So you can understand very well, ovary occupies topmost position, and calyx, corolla, androecium arises from the base of ovary. The flower is hypogynous. And here it is called as ovary is superior. Now see this figure where you can see the ovary, it is slightly embedded in the thalamus. Thalamus encircles the ovary. It is embedded in the thalamus and ovary occupies lowermost position. Here is the calyx, corolla and androecium which arises from the top of the ovary. So where ovary is at the lowermost position, it is called as inferior ovary and hence the flower is called as epigynous flower. Now this is perigynous flower. This is something different. Now here you can see this thalamus or this calyx, green color calyx, it becomes cupulate. Cupulate is cup shape. So this is cup shaped calyx or cup shaped thalamus and at the tip only the calyx lobes or sepals are free. Here are the petals and this is the stamen or androecium. Now, if you consider this as a plane, so you can see the ovary, the calyx, the corolla and androecium, they are at one plane. And so the flower is described as perigynous flower. In very few families, this perigynous flower is there. So this family is unique. So this is perigynous flower. This is hypogynous. This is epigynous. Ovary superior, ovary inferior. Here ovary is neither superior nor inferior. All the floral parts, calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium, they lie in the same plane. Then this family is belonging to order Rosales. Like we have rose family, characters are little similar, but not very similar. That's why the two families are different. The distinguishing character of Rosales is monocarpellary ovary. Mono is single, carpel is single. So single carpellate ovary. Ovary has only single carpel. So it is monocarpellary. And the leaves are alternate and stipulate. It was earlier considered under family Leguminosae and subfamily Mimosaceae, but as the botanical nomenclature changes, now it has raised to the level of family directly as a Mimosaceae. Now this family you can find in tropical, subtropical regions. The number of plants which are included in this family are comparatively less. Now, the same family or allied family to this is Fabaceae, which is the largest family in dicotyledons. But this is not that large. Only 56 genera and 2800 species are known from tropical and subtropical. In temperate regions, in colder regions, these plants, they cannot find. We cannot find them. As far as the habit is concerned, it has the trees which grows more than 50 feet in height. Shrubs which grows up to 15 feet in height, and these are the herbs which covers the ground vegetation. So I have shown all the three habits over here. So all the three habits are a type of plants belonging to this family, shows either trees or shrubs or herbs. As far as the leaves are concerned, the leaves are alternate. See here you can see this node, single leaf at each node. This entire green structure is a single leaf because this is compound. The lamina is divided into subunits and these are called as pinnae. So this particular entire thing is single leaf. So the leaves are alternate bipinnately compound. This is the main rachis, this is the secondary rachis, and on this secondary rachis, these small pinnae are present. So this is bipinnate compound leaf. You can see even to this small pinnae, there is a small stalk, so petiolate. The stipules are present. If you consider this one as a leaf, at the base of this leaf, you can see the spines. And these stipules are modified into spines. It is a characteristic feature of this particular family. As far as the inflorescence is concerned, the inflorescence is racemic or racemose inflorescence. You can see here spike. This is a spike of Prosopis shami. The flowers are in raceme inflorescence, but they are sessile and they form brush-like structure and globose heads, means rounded. I will show you the picture of individual plant so that you can see clearly what is the head inflorescence. Here, the inflorescence axis is round, and on this round inflorescence axis, you can see the flowers, they are arranged like this. Now, as far as the flowers are concerned, the flowers are complete. What do you mean by complete flower? All the four whorls are present in the flower. That means calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium. They are present in the one and the single flower. You cannot say only calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium present. They are present in the single same flower. Flowers are regular. If you divide them in any plane passing through center, they will be divided into two equal halves. For regular flowers, we use botanical term as actinomorphic. Bisexual, both androecium and gynoecium is present in one and the same flower. Flowers has a small bract. Bract is the outgrowth or some green sepaloid structures which are minute. And flowers are hypogynous, that is ovary is superior. But in initial stages, we have seen it is a perigynous, that is neither superior nor inferior. But if you see individual flower, here you can see in this picture, if you see individual flower, if you dissect this flower, you can see ovary just above the calyx gives the feeling like hypogynous. But yes, flowers are perigynous. Calyx is 4 to 5, either tetramerous or pentamerous. Sepals, they are united, so they are called as gamosepals. They are either green or petaloid. In some flowers, you find the sepals colored. So they are either green or petaloid. They are united to form either a tube or they are bell-shaped like this. The aestivation is valvate or imbricate. What is aestivation? Aestivation is arrangement of sepals and petals. Here you can see this is one corolla. Here the petals are not at all overlapping. See here, the petals are separate from each other. There is no overlapping. On the contrary, if you look at this corolla, you can see this petal is innermost. So here you can see both the ends are overlapping. So this is innermost, this is outermost. You can very well see in this diagram also. This is outermost petal, this is innermost petal. This is outermost, this is innermost. And what is the position of remaining ones? This one end is overlapping, this end is overlapping, this end is free, this end is overlapping, this end is free, this end is overlapping, this end is free. Even here also you can see overlapping end, free end. So this is imbricate aestivation, this is valvate aestivation. As per the plant species, the aestivation is either valvate or imbricate. Now, why this is important? Because whenever we are going to draw the floral diagram, we need to know the position of calyx, whether it is valvate or imbricate. And same in case of corolla. So corolla here is also made up of 4 to 5 petals. They are united, sometimes free. They are very small and valvate. See here, one flower, I have purposely drawn this diagram. See how short the calyx is, how small the corolla is, and as compared to the length of stamens, androecium. So larger part of the flower is occupied by stamens. On the contrary, the calyx and corolla are small. So in that case, you can say the calyx and corolla are small. And in androecium, we will mention that they are large. Now let us move to the androecium. Androecium 4 to many. Here you can see many stamens. They are coming out of the flower. So it is called as exertate. They are free or monadelphous. In some flowers, all these stamens, they are arranged in single bundle. Like hibiscus, it is called as monadelphous. The stamens are extrose. That is, the anthers, the opening of the stamens is facing outside the ovary or from opposite side of the ovary. Anthers are small and diathecous. There are 2 anther lobes which are joined together with the help of connective, often with deciduous glands on the top. Whenever these anthers are young, there are small glands. But why it is called as deciduous? Because as soon as the flower blooms, these glands, they fall down. So they are deciduous and they are one cell. The gynoecium, very unique, monocarpellary, single carpel is there, unilocular, superior ovary with marginal placentation, ovules are many, style long, stigma simple. See, whenever you are going to describe any gynoecium, remember this formula: number of stigma is equal to number of carpels, and number of locules is equal to number of carpels. See, here you can see one stigma, here you can see one locule. So just close your eyes and write down monocarpellary. If the 2 carpels, you will get bipid stigma. If 3, tripid. If 4, tetrapid. If 5, pentapid. And if many, you will get multiple lobes of stigma. So gynoecium is monocarpellary. Here you can see ovary is long and flat. Style is long and filiform, and stigma is simple. The placentation is marginal. This is having fruit as legume or pod. So whenever we open any pod, for example, pea pod, you can see the seeds are arranged at the margin. So this is the margin. The placenta is attached to the margin and seeds are attached to the placenta. So this is marginal placentation. The fruit is legume or lomentum. This is the lomentum, unique fruit in case of bubble. It is more constricted legume type of fruit. So it is lomentum physocarpic fruit. Pollination is usually by insects. You can see this insect is sitting just to suck the honey. We saw that honey glands are present on the anthers. So while sucking that honey unknowingly, the pollen grains, they stick to the body parts of the insect. And when they move to the second flower, the pollen grains are automatically transferred to the next flower and cross-pollination takes place. Now, the floral formula, it is a code language of a family. If you don't want to remember the entire characters of the family, if you remember only floral formula and floral diagram, you can describe the entire family. There are different symbols used over here. Let us see one by one. What is this BR stands for? BR is short form of bracteate. We saw that flowers are bracteate. They are having small bracts at the base. So we must write BR. This sign is for actinomorphic flower. We describe flower as regular. So if you divide flower in any direction, necessarily passing through the center, it is divided into two equal halves. And so this is the symbol of actinomorphic flower. This is a symbol of bisexual. If you consider this is male. If you consider this is as a female. So both male androecium and female gynoecium is present in one and same flower. So this bisexual symbol is there. K stands for calyx. We described as 4 to 5 sepals. They are united. So we put this number into brackets to just show 4 to 5 sepals. They are united. Calyx denoted by C. Again, 4 to 5 petals. They are united. Androecium, monocarpellary. Two many carpellary, but monocarpellary is more proper. Gynoecium is androecium, one to many stamens. Gynoecium, monocarpellary. And you can see here one unique sign as this dash I have made opposite to one. This is the sign of perigynous flower. But in many books, you can find this line just below one also. That means the ovary is superior. So remember both these signs in floral formula. So with the help of floral formula, what we can say? Flower is bracteate, actinomorphic, complete. Calyx made up of 4 to 5 sepals united. Corolla made up of 4 to 5 petals united. Androecium made up of 1 to many stamens. Gynoecium is monocarpellary. And it is either hypogynous or perigynous. See, all this information is hidden in this floral formula. And floral diagram talks about the estivation. This is axis. This is not related to actinomorphy or zygomorphy. Yeah? This is axis. Axis means if this is a branch and if the flower is arising at this position, this particular joint position is this axis. We must draw this axis in floral diagram. So this axis, now we will hold the flower in our hand and we'll draw this floral diagram. Here I have shown only 4 sepals. You can see 4 sepals I have drawn here. They are showing valvate estivation and I have united them. So it is united. But I have drawn these 4 petals which are free from each other. So I have drawn here polypetalous corolla. These many rounded structures are the stamens. And in the center, it is a short TS of ovary showing single ovule with marginal placentation. And another important code language in this floral diagram is this sign, which is at the base of floral diagram, it is called as bract. And when we say flower is bracteate, we must draw this bract. In some families, there are many bracts like acanthaceae, bracts and bracteoles. So around the entire floral diagram, we have to repeat these structures in case of where bracts and bracteoles are present. Now, this is a small diagram chart of family Mimosae. This is Acacia arabica plant. You can see the head or globose type of inflorescence is there. This is single flower. This is single style stigma ovary, that is carpel. This is stamen. This is marginal placentation. This is floral diagram. In many of the books, you will get these figures. Now, how this family is different than the other families? Leaves are bipinnately compound. They are stipulate and stipules are modified into spines. In allied families, in Cisalpinae and Papilionaceae, no stipules are modified into spines. In cymos, the inflorescence is cymos, head or globose type of inflorescence, which is unique in this family. Flowers are actinomorphic and small, but in both Papilionaceae, Cisalpinae, they are actinomorphic and large showy flowers. That's why they are attractive. Sepals and petals are 4 to 5 and they are valvate. Stamens are many. Coming out of the flower, so it strows. They are diathecous, that is two-celled anther. And the attachment is basifix, that is stamen is attached to the filament. Anther is attached to the filament at the base. So it is basifix. Gynoecium again, monocarpellary, superior with marginal presentation. And fruit is typical legume or lamenta. Now we'll see economic importance of this family. Very economically important plants are present in this family. The very first plant, even though it grows as a weed, we can see in barren land, these plants which are commonly growing called as Prosopis spicigera. It is also called as Shami in Marathi or Khejri. These plants are generally common in wastelands. No one is cultivating these plants. Very common at wastelands. Whenever you will find wastelands, you will find abundantly these Prosopis spicigera plants. They are small trees. They are having great medicinal values. They are used to cure the leucoderma, leprosy, asthma, dyspepsia, and it is also acts as anti-inflammatory, agagotasal, kithe apan vapru shakto, anti-convulsant, if you have the problem of getting fits, it is anti-convulsant also, antifungal, anti-cancerous, anti-diabetic. So lots of medicinal uses of these plants are there. Important thing is the leaves and pods are used as a fodder for camels and goats because they are the desert animals. And importantly, it is worshipped on Dashara day. Shamichi pana, there is a mycological myth. Pandavani, Shamicha zhadavarun, Shastra, atamade gheun, mag techyanantar aikelo manun Shamicha zhadala, dasaryacha divshi mahatva aahe. The another plant initially was known as Subabur, but later on it was named as Fubabur, that is Leucaena glauca. This is also called as house tamarind. This is a shameless plant. Once you grow in your backyard this particular plant, thousands and crores of plants will grow in every season without willing, because these pods, they came in huge number because inflorescence is great. So many flowers are present in one inflorescence, so many pods are there and every pod contains at least 10 seeds. So multiplication, they are fast growing biomass species. Initially, they were promoted by government to cultivate them on barren lands. But later on, it was found that they are competing for nutrition to the other plants. So it is termed as now Fubabur. The leaves are bipinnate, the flowers are in head. The mainly cultivated as fodder crop because this is fast growing biomass species. And all leguminosity plants, they are rich in nitrogen. So they are very good for animal fodder. And as it is a fast growing biomass yielding tree, the wood is also very useful for fuel. So in rural areas, the wood is commonly used as a fuel. So this plant is economically important. This tiny, very beautiful plant is touch me not. It is sensitive plant, Lazaro. It is an under shrub, very closely growing to the soil. Flowers are pink, globose. The peculiarity is if we touch the leaves of this particular plant, the leaves, they get closed. There is a lot of physiological mechanism behind it. You must have studied that in physiology. So that's why it is called as touch me not or Lazaro plant. This is cultivated in gardens, but also it has some medicinal uses. This is also very important plant, Acacia arabica. It is babul, Indian gum arabic. It is small tree, again growing in barren lands with having distinct yellow colored heads. You can see again spines here, bipinnately compound leaf with spines. It has large medicinal values, but its main important use is timber. Its timber is very important. The bark and pods, they are also medicinally very important. The gum is extracted from this dinka kadkat. So it is known as Indian gum arabic. It is a valuable tanning material. Tannin containing bark contains tannins, and all parts of plants are used as a fodder. Its legumes, its leaves, its fruits, etc. Timber is hard and used for wheels. बैलगाडीचे चाक वगैरे बनवण्याकरता इट इज यूज एज अ फ्युएल वुड अँड यंग ट्रीज दे आर यूज एज टूथब्रश दातून म्हणून जे विकलं जातं कडुनिंबाच्या काड्यांबरोबर तेच बाबुळाच्या काड्यांबरोबर सुद्धा असतं अँड इन द ट्रायबल रिजन ऑर इन द रुरल एरियाज स्टील द ओल्डर पीपल आर युझिंग दीज स्टेम्स एज अ टूथब्रश अँड हेन्स देअर टीथ आर हेल्दी इवन ऍट द एज ऑफ 90+ दिस इज अनदर प्लांट खैर इकॉनॉमिकली इम्पॉर्टंट अकेशिया कॅटेचू इट इज ऑल्सो हॅव्हिंग सो मेनी थॉर्न्स सो वेन वेअर वी यूज टू स्टडी दिस फॅमिली इन अवर SYBSC we remember this plant as acacia catechu because lot of thorns are there in this at the base of the leaves. This is also a deciduous tree. It is used to cure diarrhea and stomach problems such as swelling of colon, potala suzali asel tar, apachan asel, indigestion. It is also used to cure swelling, bleeding, injuries, skin diseases, etc. The important product obtained from this bark of this plant is kar or katha, and we are used this katha industrially. Industrial uses are there of this katha, and in betel wine, apan paan khato, tyachyamadhye jo kar asto, it is extracted from this. If you cut this particular twig of this plant, you will find red wood inside. That is the sign of this katha. The another plant which is commonly grown here and there, that is Albizia lebec. It is also called as shirish. Very attractive, white colored, mild fragrant flowers. But the plant is, especially after 1 month, you can see this plant entirely covered with golden color pods, and it gives very beautiful appearance. So common everywhere. Wood is hard, strong, and wood is used for furniture. This is Adenanthera pavonia. This is red bead tree. Lal manayancha jhad mantat. You can see here the pods and there are small seeds. Yala gunja asa pan mantla jata. But the gunja which we eat, it is different. And this is different. So this is inflorescence spike. This particular scarlet seeds are lens shaped. Are medicinally used as antimicrobial and hemagglutinin. The red heartwood is valuable for cabinet work and it is as a source of dye. So it is heartwood is red in color and red color dye is extracted, and because of the wood naturally having red color, the furniture is looking like shisam furniture, but it is not shisam, it is Adenanthera pavonia. This is another plant, Pithopolvium dulse, or earlier name was Inga dulse. It is in Marathi called as Vilayati chinsa. You can see these are the curd pods of this particular tree. The bark and pulp, they are astringent and they are hemostatic. Rakta pravahat, rakta thambavanyasathi excess hot aslela ani turat astat chavila. Hi sheng khalyanantar yachatla gar jar apan khalla ta apla tond asa thodasa avalyasarkho. So that is astringent, but it is medicinally used to treat gum ailments. Dantanche hridyanche azar astat tyachyasathi vapartat. To stop the toothache and the tooth bleeding, and fruits are edible. Another plant, interesting plant, is Parkia biglandulosa. It is commonly known as badminton ball tree. You can see a long stalk, and this is head inflorescence. And of course, after that, the fruits are developed. Traditionally, different parts of the plants are used in treating ulcer. It has antimicrobial, antifungal, anti-inflammatory activities. This is last plant I have taken from this family. Very beautiful garden plant. Rather, it is a shrub commonly called as powder puff. Like our powder puff, the flowers are bright red in color and it is ornamental cultivated in gardens. So I here end with this Mimosaceae, and I will quickly go through another important family, family Rubiaceae. Again, I don't want to explain all these characters as I have explained in first family, Phanerogams, Angiosperms, Dicotyledons. Difference is gamopetale, petals are united. Series inferi, as the name indicates, ovary inferior. Stamens as many as corolla lobes. That means if there are four corolla lobes, four stamens, five stamens. Flowers aggregate in globose heads, carpel number reduced. The stamens equal to corolla lobe, but carpels are generally less than the number of corolla lobe. Order is rubials. Plants are herbs or woody plants. Shrubs are rarely present. Leaves are simple, not compound like mimosa tea. Usually cymose inflorescence, the inflorescence axis directly terminate into the flower. Flowers are actinomorphic, bisexual, tetra or pentamerous, and stamens equal to corolla lobes. They are apetalous. There is always union of corolla and stamens, and ovary is inferior. There we saw ovary is superior or perigynous, neither inferior nor superior. Here is inferior. This is also small family, 380 genera, 4000 species, restricted to tropical region. Trees, shrubs, but rarely herbs are also present. So the leaves are simple, petiolate and opposite. In this figure, you can see two leaves at each node. So they are opposite. They are having stalk, so they are petiolate, and the lamina is entire. So they are simple type of leaf, not compound. Here you can see verticillate leaves. They encircle around the node, so leaves are verticillate. The stipules are present, the small outgrowth at the base of leaf. We saw there it was modified into spines. Here the stipules are having unique position. Either they are inserted within the leaf, that is intrapetiolar stipule. Leaf cha khali atle bajula aplyala stipule disto, that is intra, within the leaf. And inter means alternate to the leaves. These are interpetiolar, these are intrapetiolar. And in some cases, the stipules are modified into foliaceous or leaf-like structure. The inflorescence either solitary, you can see single flowers, one flower at each node, either corymb inflorescence. The length of the pedicel, the stalk of the flower is different, but at the top, all these 1, 2, 3 flowers are at one plane. And this is globose or head inflorescence. The flowers are complete. I will not explain again, complete actinomorphic bisexual. Yes, epigynous. Ovary inferior. So flower is epigynous. Bract is present. Pedicillate or sessile, either stalked or sessile, and tetra or pentamerous. Calyx again, 4 to 5 sepals, they are united. See in series gamopetali, calyx and corolla are united, so need not mention again and again. So 4 to 5 sepals united, they are either cup shaped and they are adnate to ovary. Adnate is alternate to ovary, valvate, sometimes enlarged and petalar. We'll see this particular feature. Here you can see the calyx. This is calyx which is united at the base and only its tips are free and it forms a small tube. Here you can see a small pedicel of the flower. This is corolla tube which is tubular, but the tips of the petals are free like this. You can see these stamens which are alternate to the petals. They are equal to number of corolla lobes. Here you can see 5 petals. So 5 stamens. And this is the gynoecium with bifid stigma. This is the flower. This is the calyx. And only one calyx is modified into bract-like structure. Attractive bract. This is just to attract the insects. So it is mentioned that sometimes enlarged and petaloid. It is color. Here you can see corolla. It is tubular. Or it is funnel shaped like this. Or it is salver shape. This is the tube and these are the limb or claws of the corolla. Androecium equal to corolla lobe. So 4 to 5 alternate with them. You can see here these are the petals and the stamens are alternate to the petals. Epipetalous, they arise above the petals. So epipetalous anthers intros facing towards the gynoecium. Two-celled, dorsifix or basifix. See, here you can see dorsifix attachment clearly. From dorsal side, the filament is attached. Gynoecium is 2 to 5 carpellary. How to decide? Number of stigma is equal to number of carpels. Number of locules is equal to number of carpels. Here I have shown pentacarpellary gynoecium. Here it is bicarpellary gynoecium. So here, style is long, filiform, ovary is globular, stigma is bifid. And again, the placentation is axial. This is axis of the ovary. Placenta is attached to the axis and ovules are attached. The fruit is either capsule, dehiscent type of fruit, and or drupe. pollination, insect pollination, again floral formula, flower is bracteate, actinomorphic, bisexual, 4 to 5 sepals united, 4 to 5 petals united, stamens equal to corolla lobes, 4 to 5 gynoecium, bicarpellary, syncarpus. Even though there are two stigmas, only one side. So it is syncarpus ovary. So syncarpus, and now the bar is at the tip of two. So this sign is inferior ovary. And this sign, where the C and A is attached, it is for epipetalous condition. So this is sign for epipetalous. This is sign for inferior. Again, floral diagram. Axis I have drawn. Here I have drawn 4 sepals which are united. You can see this union I have shown. 4 petals, and I have shown here twisted estivation. One end is overlapping, one end is free. Again overlapping, free, overlapping, free, overlapping, free. And the stamens are 4 alternate with the corolla lobe. And if you minutely observe, you can see the joint. The stamens, they are joined to the petals. So it is epipetalous condition. And in the center, axial placentation. And one more feature in this floral diagram, which I have not mentioned yet, is this, that is bract. So this is bracteate plant. So this is a drawing sheet of Ixora. Distinguishing characters, opposite whorled leaves with intra or interpetiolar stipules. In no other family, you'll find inter intrapetiolar stipules. Calyx and corolla are 4 or 5 united. Flowers regular, bisexual, epigynous. Stamens equal to corolla lobes, alternate, epipetalous and intros, ovary, inferior bilocular with axial placentation, ovary shows epigynous disc, and fruits are capsule or bean. This is also economically important family. This is Anthocephalus indicus, that is Kadamba. It is having again value in our mythology. Sri Krishna la priya sa Kadamba vruksha. This is medicinal also. This is having flowers in globose heads. You can see these are unopened flowers. These are open flowers. This is head type of inflorescence. Flowers are fragrant, having scented smell. Frequently planted on roadsides or in gardens. They are medicinal. Used to cure ailments like diabetes, diarrhea, fever, inflammation, sooz asel tar, dakta excess vaat asel tar, khokla madhe, ulti, zakman sati, brod astil, ashaktapana asel, kiva antimicrobial activity asel. So this is medicinally very important plant. This is another garden plant known as Musanda frondosa, Dobie's tree. Here you can see very clearly single bract is modified into petal. Single calyx lobe is modified into petal. Otherwise this orange color is the flower, and this is the white color, one enlarged calyx lobe. And because of this, it is cultivated in gardens. It doesn't have any medicinal value. This is another garden plant which is very fragrant. In Marathi, we called it as Ananta. In English, it is Cape Jasmine's Gardenia Florida. Very scented and beautiful flowers. Double, single varieties are there and cultivated in gardens. Apart from that, root is used to cure headache, and it is also given in fever. This is another garden plant which is known as Ixora parviflora. Parviflora is white flower. Ixora coccinea, there are many colored beautiful Ixora cultivated in gardens. Commonly called as torch tree, small evergreen shrub. The use is only cultivated in gardens. See, these are different varieties of Ixora which are commonly cultivated in gardens. Pink, blue, red, white, etc. This is economically important plant of family Rubiaceae, that is Coffea arabica. We all drink coffee, but we hardly see this particular plant. This is a branch showing the coffee beans, and these are the white colored fragrant coffee flowers. So here, these coffee beans, they are used as a beverages, and it is the main source of caffeine. And because of it is having main source of caffeine, it is used in medicines also, wherever it is required. And the popular beverage coffee is obtained from the beans, of course, not as it is, but only after processing. This is another medicinal plant. It is also called as malaria tree, that is Cinchona calicea. You can see very tiny, pink, beautiful individual flowers are there in clusters. It has medicinal value. It is treatment for fevers and malaria due to containing of quinine in it. So in consumption on high doses, if you consume this particular plant products in high dose, it causes various side effects such as severe headache, rash, abdominal pain, deafness, bahirepana yeto, synchronism, and even blindness. So this is a very important drug, but only and only used under the supervision of the physician, not on our own. This is another forest tree, Adena cordifolia. You can see the leaves are heart-shaped here, so named cordifolia. It is having pretty blooms. The flowers are pinkish, yellowish, whitish. The bark of the timber acts as an antiseptic, and wood can be used as a timber. It is a very common plant of the forest. This is another common forest plant, Mitragyna parviflora. It doesn't have any common name. The flowers are like that of kadamba. Fragrant, smooth, rounded. The bark and the roots are used to treat fever. The tribals, they use this particular plant to cure the jaundice also. The bark is used to cure colic pains. The barks and roots used to treat fever, muscular pain, burning sensation, poisoning, gynecological disorders, cough, edema, and wood of this tree is used as a timber. This is another important medicinal plant commonly called as noni, Morinda citrifolia. This is a good looking evergreen tree, but the flower, the fruits, they are having very bad odor, anti-vomit like odor, but medicinally it is important. Commonly used in various juices or drinks, of course in Ayurvedic preparations, powders. It is used in cosmetic products, in oil. Oil is extracted from seeds. Leaf powders, they are also used in pills. And this particular plant is having entire medicinal value. And the last plant from this family, last means I have taken loss, but there are many other plants. That is Randia dumetorum, that is wild pomegranate or mountain pomegranate. Dalimba sarka fruit distavaga, manun mountain pomegranate. This is common roadside in, I think, Vidarbha Khandesh. This is common roadside plant. No one has cultivated. It grows as it is. The decoction of the powdered root is applied directly on melanomas. Manje pandre je spots astat kod. Tyachyavarti directly tyachi paste lavta. The infusion is administered orally as an emetic. Kontya hot astil tar to relieve fever, nausea, general coughs, toothache, pains. And during pregnancy, they are used dizziness. थोड़ा सा अपन म्हणतो की सुचत नाहीये काही मंदाव सगळं मंदावलंय dizziness, menorrhagia, menstrual flows are extra होत असेल तर त्याच्यातही वापरला जातो and it is very important in snake bites. So this is about these two families which are included in the syllabus of SRTM University Nanded. With the permission of Dr. Arvind Chavan, if students have any questions, the platform is open for discussion. Or otherwise, over to you, sir. I have done.
Thank you. Thank you very much, ma'am, for a nice presentation on systematic botany. And you have covered the topic nicely. I think this is a topic not only the syllabus of the university, but it is also relevant for our day-to-day life. Even though a few of the plants were, we needed somewhere else in our daily routine.
Yes.
I hope the student all were enjoy this session. Now I request if the student have any query on this topic, they can ask directly, ma'am. Otherwise, I will move for the feedback. Now I request Dr. Vishal Marathi sir to give a feedback on ma'am's session. Ma'am, Dr. Vishal Marathi sir is also a taxonomist. He's from Amravati, currently working as assistant professor in NDS Science College, Nanded.
Hello,
yeah. Marathi sir, please unmute yourself.
Unmute yourself. Marathi sir, unmute yourself.
Just wait a moment, sir. I will allow you to unmute. Sir, please unmute.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Arvind Chauhan, sir. Good afternoon to all the participants. It's my really pleasure for me to listen to Dr. Ravi Radhika. You might not be recognized, but I know you since 2009. I was very fortunate to meet with you in 2009 when you are working at MJ College, Jalgaon. Besides, you are very busy schedule. You have given a wonderful lecture on the subject of taxonomy, because you know that taxonomy is the most neglected and most boring subject according to students. And because this subject was not taught properly, because we have taught this subject, they are not having knowledge regarding this subject, but just as it is allowed in them, they have taught this subject, but they have not influenced the student to learn from this subject. But it's really a pleasure for me, because Dr. Arvind has sent me the link, and I was very fortunate, and I am really thankful to Dr. Arvind Chauhan that you have provided me the link of this lecture, and so that I was really enjoy the lecture of Dr. Arvind. Actually, math has covered too well, because plant taxonomy is a very vast subject. But because of the lack of time, math has just covered two families. But these two families, whatever math has given in his in her lecture, actually she has elaborated all the morphological and plural characters. Actually, to study or to understand the family, it is very important to elaborate each and every taxonomic characters, and these taxonomic characters, particularly these are the technical terms, and because of these technical terms, most of the students they neglected these families to study these families. And whatever the botanical names and all these parameters, they are very difficult to understand, very difficult to mug up. Actually, this subject is considered as a volatile subject, because moreover, they are understand this subject, but they are not remember. But ma'am has given a very peculiar explanation to each and every technical terms. So it's really wonderful, or it's really helpful for the student to understand each and every terminologies, which are very important as a diagnostic characteristic feature of these families. Because to understand the family, they have to remember the diagnostic characters. Because most of the characters are general characters, they are very common in all families, but diagnostic characters are very important, and they have to be remembered by the students. So, really, I am enjoying the lecture which is given by Dr. Ravi Rani ma'am. As I just come to know that you are working as a professor and working as a principal in Dr. Anna Sahib Bhandari Mahavidyalaya, Jalgaon. I congratulate ma'am for this, and I really thank you to the organizer, particularly Dr. Panjab Chauhan, sir, principal of this college, as they have given an opportunity for such lecture series. Actually, they are organizing continued classroom teaching program for the students, and I am really thankful to my friend Dr. Arvind Chauhan, sir. I am really thankful to Dr. Tawri, sir, for giving this opportunity, and really your lecture was very good and very well explained lecture. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir, for your valuable and peaceful word. Now I request Dr. Elvis Shinde, sir, for another feedback over this session. Please, Elvis Shinde, sir.
Thank you, sir. Today Dr. Gauri Rane madam, she has been given us a practical knowledge as well as theoretical knowledge. Once I am asking question to himself that the in our contemporary classroom there was the theoretical aspect, but madam has given tremendous practically. She has been put to us in the botanical garden, many, many medicinal plants, medicinal flowers, she has been demonstrated to us. Some plants, those are with us, but we are unknown from it, like subabul. Later on, some khair, lajalu, touch me not plants. And those plants have much more valuable medicinal uses. She has been detected in her class. So once more, I thanks to ma'am that she, our Dr. Gauri Rane madam, she has been given a tremendous knowledge to us. And her knowledge, it has been published to students like us. She has been published near about 47 books. So I once more thanks to ma'am, the great knowledge, it has been published for the students who are hungry for this knowledge. And in the introduction, Mr. Arvind Chauhan, sir, he has been introduced the well, an ideal, and the pole star works of Mrs. Dr. Gauri Madam, Gauri Rane Madam. At that time, Madam has been stopped that. Please come to the point. Once more, I think that the great men never make a show of their good deeds. And from this aspect, the huge knowledge, the pole star, which always guide to us, which are the wandering ships in the seas. तर अशा प्रकारे एखाद्या समुद्रामध्ये भरकटणारी जी जहाज आहेत त्यांना पोलस्टार म्हणून काम करणाऱ्या अशा मार्गदर्शक आमच्या आजच्या या कार्यक्रमासाठी उपस्थित कंटेन्ट क्लासरूम साठी उपस्थित झालेल्या गौरी राणे मॅडम त्यांचं पुनश्च एकदा या ठिकाणी मी आभार व्यक्त करतो. अँड वन्स मोर आय थँक टू मिस्टर अरविंद चव्हाण सर अँड देअर प्रिन्सिपल डॉक्टर विनायकराव चव्हाण सर. They have been arranged the controlled classroom for the students, and this controlled classroom has been played an ideal impact for those who are stayed at the home. Thank you, sir. Thank you once more.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir, for your valuable words. Listen, sir. I think principal ma'am, like Gauri Rane madam, I think principal were never available for the faculty and student for the teaching purpose, sir, especially.
First of all, I am a teacher and then I become principal because I was teacher. And more experience as a teacher than a principal.
That's yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. But yeah, ma'am. But the principal has many more tasks to do. So that's why I am saying, ma'am. But from such a your busy livelihood, really busy official work hours, you have taken a time for us. For that, I from my deep of my heart, I once again thank you and handed over this session to our faculty in charge, Dr. Sachin Tavade sir, to propose vote of thanks for this session, for today's last session. Dr. Tavade sir, over to you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Arvind Chauhan sir.
You're welcome, sir.
Today's our guest of honor, we can say Dr. Gauri Rane Madam, who is professor in Department of Botany since 2014. Also, Madam is working as principal. And as you already said, that principals, they are having so many tasks. And with their busy schedule, Madam has given the valuable time as well as their valuable knowledge they have shared with us as well as the students of this state of Maharashtra. Definitely this lecture which is delivered by ma'am, it has given more information which has be very important to the students who are learning in UG as well as PG botany, because these topics, they are in BSc as well as in MSc program also. The students have to study this systematic botany. Madam, really wonderful presentation, nice slides, beautiful photographs, and with that knowledgeable presentation, I also learned so many things, how to present the systematic botany particularly, or how to deliver the topic to the students so that they will get more benefit. Really nice presentation, ma'am. I also learned so many things as our different professors like Dr. Marathe sir, who is working in taxonomy, sir has given their feedback. Nicely presented your topic, ma'am. Also, our another professor, Shinde sir, sir has also gave their feedback that you have nicely presented your work and which will be benefited, which will be useful for the students who are watching this program live, or the students who are not presently watching this program, but with the YouTube link, they will definitely watch this program and they will gain the knowledge of systematic botany. Particularly, you have delivered two different families, that is Mimosaceae or Rubiaceae. So both these families you have given with a very, very good presentation, ma'am. So being head of the department as well as in charge faculty of science, I myself or on the behalf of organizing committee, I am very much thankful to Honorable Dr. Gauri Rane ma'am, and we keeping hopes that whenever we will arrange some programs, definitely will be the part of the events of our college too.
Sure,
thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, Arvind sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. And thank you once again, Gauri Rane ma'am. And from the organizer side, I declare that the session is end here. Tomorrow, on Monday, we will tune at 10 o'clock morning with two sessions a day. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, ma'am, for your valuable time. And thank you, participant. I hope you have enjoyed this session.